It's not surprising considering its crushing debt and falling revenues. News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter live in the Vermont newsroom tonight with our third story. And Stu, this really does come as no surprise.
No, not at all, Stephanie. Critics have long predicted this could happen. Given the $2.7 billion in debt this fairly small company took on when it bought Verizon's Northern New England landline business last year. Today, FairPoint stock was suspended from trading, even as its executives sought to portray the reorganization as good news.
On the day FairPoint Communications filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy, its CEO tried to calm worried customers and employees.
The most important thing for you to know is that we are not going out of business.
In a conference call with reporters, CEO David Hoosier said the company needed to reorganize, despite cutting $1.7 billion in debt in a deal with its lenders.
This is good news and will make FairPoint more viable and competitive than ever.
And Hoosier says the company is more committed than ever to rolling out its next generation high-speed DSL broadband technology early this winter.
State regulators sure hope so. Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine have all badgered FairPoint for months to improve service quality amid a barrage of complaints.
FairPoint claims that it won't have an impact to consumers, and we plan to hold them to that.
But it's unclear now whether the state's legal options have narrowed with the bankruptcy filing. And though FairPoint employees expected the news, they too have all kinds of questions.
And they're concerned. They want to know, what does it mean for them, for their future? I got senior people want to know, should they retire? Should they bail? Is it a sinking ship?
The company is asking its unions for concessions, health benefits and work rules among them.
We've always offered that we want to be a partner with the company to make the company successful going forward. However, that's not going to be done on the backs of the union.
On almost every front, FairPoint appears headed for a stormy winter ahead.
The company elected to file for bankruptcy in New York City, not in its service territory in northern New England, which its unions say is no accident. The first court hearing is tomorrow. Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine have all hired legal teams to represent consumers during this process, which Hoosier told us today could take several months to resolve. Live in the Vermont newsroom, I'm Stuart Ledbetter.